Hi, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, we're going to explore some basic ways project managers can take advantage of Microsoft OneNote. Microsoft OneNote doesn't get nearly the credit it deserves as a remarkably powerful tool to support project managers. You can use OneNote as a soup-to-nuts solution where you store everything from your meeting notes, generate and manage your to-do list, add links to where relevant files are located, share your OneNote notebooks, and more. OneNote is incredibly flexible, and every project manager will invariably use it a little bit differently, but this is definitely a tool that's worth project managers adding to their tool belt. The first area where Microsoft OneNote adds value is meeting notes. Project managers will often create meeting notes directly in an email that will get sent out to the team after the meeting in Microsoft Word or in some other word processing application. Over the course of a project, meeting notes will often live in separate files, making them difficult to go back through if you're looking for one particular item that may or may not have been documented in a meeting months ago. You can create a primary page for your meeting notes in a OneNote notebook section with your project, and then create subpages for all of your subsequent meeting notes. You can keep your notes directly in the OneNote page using either the built-in bullets or numbering system, similar to how you would add levels in Microsoft Word. The best part is that if you do build out all your meeting notes in Microsoft OneNote, everything will be searchable, so you can find key terms from old notes in seconds rather than hours. The next thing that OneNote lets you do easily is create and manage a to-do list. If you're a project manager juggling multiple complex projects, keeping track of all reminders you create for yourself over the course of the day can be an absolute nightmare. Those reminders end up scattered across meeting notes, sticky notes, and piles of paper. They rarely ever all get collected in one place, and they may never make it back on your radar until you get an angry phone call from your boss reminding you to do something. Creating a to-do list as a page at the top of a Microsoft OneNote notebook section where you store information for your project gives you easy access to that information. If you created your meeting notes in OneNote, you can simply copy the relevant items you want to pull into your to-do list for that project into that separate list. From there, you can right-click on any of the items in a list to tag that item as a to-do item with a checkbox, an important item with a star icon, an idea with a light bulb icon, a password with a lock icon, and more. Additionally, if you have Microsoft Outlook set up on your computer, you can also create reminder flags associated with those items that will also display and pop up in Outlook. The next big benefit of Microsoft OneNote is the ability to easily link to relevant files. You can also either add shortcut links to relevant files on your computer or websites inline anywhere in your document. Additionally, you can insert active versions of Microsoft files directly in your OneNote pages. Alternatively, you can insert some files that are not associated with Microsoft applications, but they will display as a PDF if they can be displayed at all. The links can be especially helpful if you build a page within your project's notebook section out as a table of contents for your project's files and then link back to them. This will let you access those files quickly from one location without having to work your way through a bunch of folders to get what you need. The final basic value add associated with using Microsoft OneNote is easy sharing. Perhaps the best part of Microsoft OneNote is that if you have a OneNote notebook section dedicated to a project, you can easily share that notebook section with anyone else who has OneNote. You can email that specific section, or you can go out to the location where it's saved, copy it, and send it to that person via other means. A good use case around this is if you're going on vacation and if you need to get someone up to speed on your project so they can serve as a point person while you're out, you can send them your OneNote file and literally give them all of the information about the project. Additionally, if the files you call out within the link are in a shared location where the other person can access them, they'll be able to easily find your files as well.